Hello friends, in this video I'm going to discuss about singular points. First, let us come to the definition of singular points. A point xy through which pass k branches of the curve fxy is equal to 0 is called a multiple or singular point of order k. Means if we have any point xy on the curve fxy is equal to 0 through which k branches of the curve passes, then this point is called a multiple or singular point of order k. For example, if I have this curve, then at this point 50, two branches of the curve, one is this and second one is this, two branches of the curve passes, therefore this point 50 is a multiple point of order 2 here, since here we have two branches, therefore it is a multiple point of order 2. Further, multiple point of order 2 is called a double point, and of order 3 is called a triple point. Since here we have two branches, therefore it is a multiple point of order 2. That is, it is a double point. Also, from the graph, it is clear that a curve has k tangents at a multiple point of order k. Here, order is 2, and clearly it is clear from this graph that it has two tangents. Here, k is 2, means a curve has two tangents at a double point. Okay, now we come to the nature of double points. We are going to discuss double points in detail in this video. First, come to nature of double points. First is, a double point is called a node if the two tangents at that point are real and distinct. Condition is that a double point is node if we know if it is a double point, it has two tangents at that point. Further, if two tangents at that point are real and distinct, then that double point is called the node. For example, consider the curve y square is equal to x minus 2 into x minus 5 whole square. Graph of this curve is of this form. Okay, now we have to check, we will find the tangents, two tangents to this curve, and check if the two tangents are real and distinct. If it is so, then the point will be a node. Okay, we have to find the tangent, we have to find the point which is double point, and check if the tangents are real and distinct or not. Now, curve given to us is y square is equal to x minus 2 into x minus 5 whole square. Now, the two branches of the curve, two branches of the curve are y is equal to plus minus square root of x minus 2 into x minus 5. These are the two branches. Okay, now we have to find a point, double point. Okay, now it is clear from this y is equal to plus minus square root of x minus 2, x minus 5, that point 50 is common to two branches. It is clear. Now the point 50 is common to the two branches. Therefore, 50.50 is a double point. Now we will find the tangent at this double point. Okay, this point is double point. It is clear since it is common to the two branches of the curve. Therefore, 50 is a double point. Now next, we have to find the tangent at the point 50. For this, we have to find the dy by dx first. Now, differentiating with respect to x both sides, dy by dx is equal to plus minus, applying product rule of differentiation, this is 1 by 2 x minus 2 minus 1 by 2 into x minus 5 plus, and differentiation of x minus 5 is 1, this is equal to square root of x minus 2, applying product rule of differentiation. Okay, now at the point 50, dy by dx is equal to, this will be 0, this is plus minus 5 minus 2 square root, that is square root 3. Therefore, tangents to above two branches at 50 are at this is x1 y1 y minus y1 is equal to plus minus root 3 x minus x1, that is x minus 5, that is y is equal to plus minus square root 3 x minus 5. That means one tangent is y is equal to plus root 3 x minus 5, and the second tangent is y is equal to minus 5 square root 3 into x minus 5. Therefore, clearly two tangents are real and distinct. So double point 50 is a node by definition, means first we have to find the two branches, then the common point, and then the tangent at that point. This is a way to check whether a given double point, whether a point is node or not. Second nature is a double point is called a cusp if two tangents at that point are real but coincident, means same. Second is, if we have a double point, at that point two tangents are real but same or coincident, then in that case that double point is called cusp. Let us consider the example. Consider the curve y square into 2a minus x is equal to x square. Now consider this curve. Okay, this is the graph of this curve. Then clearly this is one branch, this is second branch, and the point 0,0 is common to the two branches. Okay, now two branches are y is equal to plus minus square root of x cube by 2a minus x. The point, it is clear from the graph, the point 0,0 is common to both branches, means this point is a double point since two branches of the curve passes from this point 0,0. Therefore 0,0, or in other words 0,0 is common to both branches. Therefore this point is a double point. Now we have to find the two tangents at this point. Okay, now for this we have to find the dy by dx. Now dy by dx at 0,0 we have to find, differentiating y with respect to x both sides. This is 1 by 2 x cube 2a minus x minus 1 by 2 into, now applying the quotient rule of differentiation, this is equal to 2a minus x whole square 2a minus x into 3x square minus x cube into minus 1. This is my dy by dx. Now at the point 0,0, we have to find dy by dx at the point 0,0. This is 0, that means whole is 0. Therefore tangents to above two branches at 0,0, this is my x1, this is my y1, tangents are given by y minus y1 is equal to dy by dx at the point 0,0 into x minus x1, that is 0 here, that is y is equal to 0, that is x-axis. Means we have a real but coincident tangent. Same tangent, y is equal to 0. Clearly, it can be seen from this graph, this x-axis is a tangent at the point 0, 0. Means we have two tangents which are real but coincident. Therefore, from the definition, the double point, therefore, double point 0, 0 is a cusp. Since two tangents are real but coincident. Therefore, by definition, this double point 0, 0 is a cusp. We have third type also. And third type is a double point is called a conjugate point or isolated point if two tangents at that point are imaginary. Means complex, not real. For example, consider the curve AY square is equal to X into X plus A whole square, A greater than 0. Okay. Now, this is my curve. Two branches of the curve are given by Y is equal to plus minus. Taking square root, I get this as X plus A whole square upon A. Now, from this, y is equal to plus minus this, it is clear that point minus a is 0. The point minus a is 0 is common to both the branches. On substituting, x is equal to minus a here, I get y is equal to plus minus 0. That is 0 in any case. Therefore, this point is common to both the branches. Therefore, this point is a double point. Okay, now same procedure, we have to find the dy by dx at this point and then we will find the tangents at that point. Now, y can also be rewritten as plus minus 1 upon square root of a square root of x into x plus a. Now, dy by dx, differentiating both sides with respect to x on applying product rule of differentiation will give us, this is 1 by 2 x minus 1 by 2 x plus a plus square root of x, and differentiation of this is 1. Therefore, now at the point minus a 0, dy by dx will be equal to, this will be 0. Therefore, this will be plus minus 1 upon under root a into under root of minus a. Minus means here we have complex root, not a real root. This is plus minus iota, where iota is square root of minus 1. Means we are having a imaginary value, not a real value of dy by dx. Okay. Now, equation of tangent will be given by at minus a 0 is given by y minus 0 is equal to plus minus iota into x plus a. That is, y is equal to plus minus iota into x plus a. That means we have two tangents but which are imaginary. Okay, we are having iota here, not a real value. Okay, means tangents are imaginary. Therefore, double point minus a 0 is conjugate or isolated point. This is the definition of conjugate point or isolated point. Okay, these are the three types of double point. Next, we come to next topic, tangents at the origin. Tangents at the origin. We have already discussed the part of tangents at any point. Now, at the point origin, we have a special rule We can easily find the tangents at the origin using this rule, and the rule says that the equation of tangents to the curve fxy is equal to 0 at the origin, means 0, 0, is obtained by equating the lowest degree terms to 0. Means we have to simply equate the lowest degree terms to 0 to obtain the equation of tangents at the point 0, 0. Okay, consider the examples to understand this rule more clearly. First example, find the equation of tangent at the origin to the curve x square minus 4a square is equal to y square x square minus a square. We have to find the tangent at the origin. Now we can write this equation of curve in this form. On simplifying, this is x4 minus 4a square x square minus x square y square plus a square y square is equal to 0. Now equation of the tangent at the origin to any curve is obtained by equating the lowest degree terms to 0. Okay, now equation of tangent at the origin is obtained by equating the lowest degree terms to 0. That is, this rule says, now here lowest degree term, here its degree is 4, here it is 2. That means one lowest degree is this, here also 2 plus 2 4, and it is 2. That means lowest degree terms is minus 4a square x square plus a square y square is equal to 0. This is the equation of tangent at the origin. Now this can be written as ay whole square minus 2ax whole square. I can write this equation in this form. That means this is applying the formula of a square minus b square, which is a minus b into a plus b, will give me ay minus 2ax, and ay plus 2ax is equal to 0, which further will give me ay is equal to 2ax and ay is equal to minus 2ax. This a will get cancelled out. That is, y is equal to 2x and y is equal to minus 2x. That is, y is equal to plus minus 2x. This is how we have to find the equation of tangent at the origin. Now, equation of tangent at the origin of this particular question or particular curve given to us is given by y is equal to plus minus 2x. Okay. Next, we consider next example. Now, consider this second one. Find the equation of tangents to the curve x cube plus xy square plus 2ax square plus 2ay square plus 4axy plus 5a square x plus 8a square y plus 8a cube is equal to 0. At the point minus a minus 2a and show that it is a node. Okay, curve given to us is this, and the point at which we have to find the tangent is minus a minus 2a. That is, it is other than the origin. For this, we will shift our origin to this point. See here, this point is origin 0, 0, and minus a 2a will be somewhere here, minus a minus 2a. Now we have to find the tangent at this point. For this, I will shift my origin at this point. We have to shift our origin at this point, minus a minus 2a. Okay, we will shift our origin from 0, 0 to minus a minus 2a by substituting. First, we shift the origin to the point minus a minus 2a. For this, put x is equal to, small x is equal to capital X minus a, and y is equal to capital Y minus 2a. We are shifting our origin from 0, 0 to minus a minus 2a with the help of this new coordinate capital X and capital Y, where capital X and capital Y are current coordinates of a point with respect to new set of axes. Okay, we have shifted our origin from here to this with respect to new set of coordinates capital X and capital Y. Now we will find the equation of tangent at this point with respect to X and Y. Now here it will be origin with respect to capital X and capital Y, and I can apply my rule directly here of finding tangent at the origin. That rule we can apply here with respect to this X and Y coordinates, capital X and capital Y coordinates. Okay, and then again from capital X and capital Y we can shift to this point 0, 0. Okay, now on substituting this, the equation of curve then transforms to x minus a whole cube plus x minus a y minus 2a whole square plus 2a x minus a whole square plus 2a y minus 2a whole square plus 4a x minus a y minus 2a plus 5a square x minus a plus 8a square y minus 2a plus 8a cube is equal to 0. Now we have to simplify this equation. On simplification, this equation will be of the form x cube minus ax square plus xy square plus ay square is equal to 0. Okay, now equation of tangent at 0, 0 is with respect to new set of axes capital X and capital Y is given by equating to 0 the lowest degree terms, this and this. It is of degree 3, it is also of degree 3, 1 plus 2. Therefore, this is minus ax square plus ay square is equal to 0. That is, y is equal to plus minus x. Okay. Now, from this, y is equal to plus minus x. Now, by substituting capital X is equal to x plus a and capital Y is equal to y plus 2a. We find that equation of tangents at minus 2a to given curve are y plus 2a is equal to plus minus x plus a, that is y plus 2a is equal to x plus a, one tangent is this, and y plus 2a is equal to minus x minus a, this is the second tangent, that is y is equal to x minus a and y is equal to minus x minus 3a. Okay, these are the two tangents. Now since two tangents are real and distinct, by definition the point minus a minus 2a is a node. By definition of node, this point is a note, since two tangents at this point are real and distinct, therefore this point is a note. Okay, that's it for this video. In my next video, I'm going to discuss some more problems on singular points and tangents. If you have any queries or any suggestions, please write to me in comment box. Thank you.